everybody. Welcome to another episode of Disney Lost Boys, where loving Disney has no has no age. So, I'm here with my two of my fellow Lost Boys today, Andy and Nick. And today, we are gonna, so Nick, where are we heading first today on our adventure?
Well, first we're gonna head to Hollywoodland, and we're gonna take a look at the sneak peek of the Mission Breakout of the Guardian of the Galaxy.
Right. Nice. All right. Yeah, we're going to head on over to get a quick glimpse of Guardians of the Galaxy Mission Breakout, which they're slowly taking away the tarp so we can see what's going on the outside. And from the look of it, from this distance, it definitely looks like the model. Definitely looks like the concept art, would you say?
Yep.
Yeah, I'm super excited about it. Tim, how do you, Tim's not with us today. It's like, he couldn't make it today, unfortunately. So, Nick, how do you feel about Guardians of the Galaxy taking over Tower Terror?
Well, from the beginning, like, right before I was about to leave, I was so upset. I mean, I was a little bit disappointed, but now, but then I just checked out the, about how it looks, and I was like, wow.
Oh, yeah.
And, so I'm still gonna go on the ride just the heck of it, see if it's better than the Tower Terror. So I'm gonna just,
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. Like, definitely go on the ride with an open mind. That's like the thing that we definitely, need to do for, Guardians of the Galaxy, because it has a lot to live up to, especially when going up against Tower.
Yeah.
So just go in with a clean slate and enjoy the ride for what it is. Because it's pretty much the same type of ride, it's just a different theme.
Yeah.
So, all right, so we'll check with you guys right back once we head on over to Mission Breakout.
Wow.
All right, so we are right here in front of the exterior of Guardians of the Galaxy Mission Breakout, which is opening on May 25th, is that right? You think so, Nick? I think that's right, May 25th?
Okay, but it says summer 2017 over here.
Yeah, it says, says escaping summer 2017, but it's gonna come out in May. I'm super excited. So, looking at it close up, Nick, what do you think? Looks cool, right? Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, for to be honest, I mean, I do like how they design of the Guardian of the Galaxy Mission Breakout, and for most of the time, I'm definitely gonna go on the ride just to see if it's better than Tower Terror.
Right, or if it lives up to it.
Yeah, just to check it out.
Right, just to check it out. Just out of curiosity.
Yeah.
Right. And how about you, Andy? Any thoughts about Mission Breakout from just by looking at from the outside?
Yeah, it looks pretty awesome. They're building it, and
Well, I'm not sure I'm gonna be into that ride yet.
Right. Yeah, I know about you and thrill rides, so
yeah,
that's okay. But personally, I'm very excited for it. It looks phenomenal. I mean, like they already got the collector's logo up there on the top. Let me see if I get a zoom in right there. It's under the scaffoldings right there. But yeah, it's gonna be great. They already got the backside done. They just need to complete the front side. So I'm really excited for it. And yeah, so this summer, during the Summer of Heroes, Guardians of the Galaxy will open.
Yeah.
Super excited. So, let's see. Nick, any ideas of what should we do as of right now? Should we want to keep on adventuring here in DCA, or want to head on over to Disneyland? Because we still got Pirates to go to, so.
Of course we do. And, well, for right now, I mean, since we're heading over to Bugsland, I mean, I'm not sure we're going to do anything at Bugsland.
Right. Maybe we're probably going to walk around DCA, right?
Yeah.
Just see what we can do before we head on over to Disneyland, right?
Yeah, just to see which rides we can go on, like, if it's okay with us.
Yeah. All right.
That's right.
All right. Sounds like a plan. All right. We'll check back with you guys real soon. All right. First ride of the day. Little Mermaid Ariel's Undersea Adventure, one of our favorite attractions here in Disney's California Adventure. So, Andy, ready to go under the sea?
Huh?
Ready to go under the sea?
Yes.
Yes? How about you, Nick?
All right.
So, actually, hold on. While we wait in line, I actually have a... Want to do a quick game? Okay. In honor of Beating the Beast coming out in theaters, I'm going to ask you guys some trivia questions about the film. First one to 3 points wins, okay? Sounds like a plan? All right. Here we go. Nick and Andy, first question. What is the name of Belle's horse?
Belle's horse?
Yeah, what is the name of Belle's horse?
Where she lives or something?
What?
Where she lives, or?
Oh no, what's the name of her horse?
Oh, Philip.
I'll take that, close. It's Philippe. Yeah, I'll give you the point, it was close. Okay, a point for Andy. All right, next question. What is the first song in the movie? Correct, it's Belle. Nice. Okay, next question. Ooh, which character sings the song Beauty and the Beast?
Miss Potts.
Correct. All right, that's a point for Andy. Needs one more point to win. All right, next one. Ooh, let me think of one. Okay. How many years have the Beast and the Castle Servants been cursed? How many? How many years have Beast and the Castle Servants have been cursed?
20 years.
How many?
20.
20? That is incorrect. How about you? Do you have an answer?
Like 30?
Nope. The correct answer is 10 years.
10 years?
Okay. Since we're getting close to the ride, one more question. This will be the bonus one, and this one wins the prize. And the question is... hold on. Which two characters sing the song Be Our Guest?
Lumiere and Miss Potts.
Yeah. There we go. Yeah, Lumiere and Miss Potts. You guys got it. Nice. All right. You know what? Just for that, I would say that you guys both won. You guys are... Yeah. You guys truly know your Beauty and the Beast. And without further ado, we are here. We are at Ariel's Undersea Adventure. So, without further ado... let's head under the sea.
What a voice. What a beautiful voice. But let me tell you of that evil sea witch tricked Ariel's voice away from her. Oh, this is a great story. First, Ariel fell in love with a youth. Then, King Triton, an old man, and told Sebastian and Grant to watch over him. Then, there was lots of singing! Oh, that was fun. And then, the story began when Ariel fell out of the
to live happily ever after.
flesh. But you'll find that nowadays I've mended all my ways, repented, seen the light, and made a switch. Yes. Poor unfortunate souls in pain, in need. This one longing to be thinner, that one wants to get the girl, and do I help her?
Yes, indeed.
Those poor unfortunate souls, so sad, so true.
Collect your belongings and walk to the nearest exit. We hope you'll
come swing again soon with our silly symphony.
What's up, guys? We're here with Kyle Paala, also known as Maui. So,
what's up, everybody?
Yeah.
Yeah. So anyway, like, I want to ask Kyle, or as in Maui, a question. Like, hey, how does it feel like when you get to talk to people as Maui as a character?
Dude, you know what's awesome, man? When I first saw the movie come out at D23, I've had so many people come up to me around that, like, oh my gosh, you're like the live person. I mean, I think if you ask any other Polynesian that look like me, I mean, I think it'll look like that. But one thing I'm really proud of is the makers of the movie, like how they went out of their way to, you know, travel and, you know, discover and actually get to know what our culture, our people, our land, and everything's about. So I really appreciate the movie.
Yeah, that's awesome, man. Yeah, I mean, we all love the movie, and we're all happy to see you as Maui. So thank you guys. So hopefully we'll catch you on later on today.
Yeah.